So they are not valid. They have only been transformed from one state to another. Like the ice melting into water, water getting vaporized as much.
So space and time is an absolute reality and is not an illusion.
Look here, it's an illusion to the extent that it is filtered through our psyche. Whatever we know of anything is a filtered product of the psyche. So, you cannot say that, what was it about the question?
I was asking if space and time were illusions or if they were, had an absolute existence.
I tell you, I don't understand this illusion and reality. Because reality consists of also imaginary quantities. Einstein also dealt with imaginary quantities as measures of reality. So I really don't understand this, that invidious distinction between, you know, the cause, illusion and reality.
Take a piece of
well, if you think that anything that has been filtered through the psyche is an illusion, yes, it's an illusion. Because we don't know what it will be like if we were not imbued with a human psyche. I don't know how this chair looks to the dog.
What when you're disembodied? Well, in other words, the release of the soul, does the soul still have that psyche with which things are filtered?
Of course.
So that's gone?
No. Then the stage comes where the psyche and the soul separate at two consumes.
Yeah, no.
Alright.
Yeah. Like two motives separate. So that is what we call salvation. When this soul has been, or the spirit has been even left that little appendage, the psyche, that little filter.
Well, I guess
but we can't conceive or perceive what it will be like without the psyche. Because we can't. We have no language for it, no. We may know it, but we can't transmit it language. We can transmit it through spirit, yeah.
Is it true what Prabhupada says, that if you say the name of God when you die, your soul will not be bound to matter anymore?
Provided you have got trust in God. Provided. If not, then the answer is no.
Where does it go?
That means it depends on your psychic disposition at the time of death.
What is the dividing line?
Because what is this taking name of? When you take name of something, you remember. You identify yourself with him. You try to visualize. You try to communicate with him. You try to, you know, what they call retrieve the memories that have been embedded in your brain cells. And bring that into active perception. When you remember a thing, you remember the whole thing, whole situation, all intercommunication, entire drama, including the machine, which is taking part in the drama.
Is that what the Tibetan Book of the Dead, the Bodos, is about?
The what?
Is that what the Bodos and the Tibetan Book of the Dead is about?
In an archaic way, yes. Not in a very scientific and proven and cut and clipped way in which I am putting forward. In an archaic way, yes. In a right brain way, yes.
If we can take faith with us when we die, well...
No, if you have already a basic faith in God, and you take the name of God, then your mind, because that mind is very now flexible, very clear now, then it catches the signal. And that, in the resonance phrase, once you catch one resonance, you go into the series of resonance. And God is the totality of all resonance. Well, there are chances that only by remembering the name of God at the time of dissociating from this body, you may be completely, you know, merged in the cosmic whole.
So
then you, not that you are completely debarred from returning, if you wish you can come. As Lord Buddha said, that I will come again and again, till the last sentinel of humanity has been salvated, has attained salvation, has attained nirvana, has attained emancipation. So you are not bound to, not to come back, but you have, for once at least, has an inkling of the cosmic wholeness, you know, without being fettered by the body. That is what salvation amounts to. Salvation army notwithstanding. Notwithstanding.
Is it true that you can be saved at death no matter what kind of life you've led? If you, on your deathbed, would then have...
Yes. Because that is a great term of psychic association. How quickly psyche can be transformed by association with ideas. How quick. Here's my witness. She's a psychiatric doctor, she's MD, psychiatrist, she's a... So I can't really bluff.
It seems like the Christians have too much of a loophole. They live, some of them live such unaware lives, and they say they'll be saved at their deaths.
Yes.
It seems like it's too easy.
What? Because they are taking the name of God. Same thing what Prabhupada is saying, also has been said by Christ. What did Christ do? He was, you know, invoking his Father. Father, forgive them, what they don't know what they're doing. So he was invoking God. So his mind was associated with that cosmic principle which we call God. So what's wrong with you? By association you can be, even. But unless you have practiced to remember God all your life, you can't do it at the last moment. So that is why the provision for prayers, for self-remembrance, for remembrance of God, remembrance of Mother Nature and things like that. Spiritual. We cannot go spirit, you know, in psychic terms, no. We can only know spirit in ultra-psychic terms, on paranormal terms.